I'm Clemente De Lucia, an economist with BNP Paribas in London. Today, I would like to speak with you regarding growth, inflation, and what, based on our scenario, the ECB will do. To tackle this angle, let me start from what we know from the Governing Council of the ECB. At its press conference in June, President Draghi said that the ECB is confident regarding growth, but is probably less confident regarding the pace of inflation, which is remaining low despite growth being strong, and suggesting that probably the ECB will wait, is becoming a little bit data dependent to regarding this exit strategy. What we think? Well, based on our analysis, growth is strong. It's strong because we saw domestic demand doing well within the zone. We saw unemployment declining. We saw the output gap, the slackness in the economy declining. And also the countries within the zone are doing well. We saw Germany doing well, but also France is also expanding at a relative quite pace, strong pace. And also Italy is also doing well. So there is this positive cycle within the zone, which is also protecting the Eurozone from external developments. So all these elements make the Eurozone strong, domestically driven, protected from the external. So this element is strong. From this strong, we saw employment increasing, unemployment declining, and this will push some pressure in wages. And therefore, we see wage inflation increasing over the coming quarters, and this will push inflation higher. In this scenario, we think the ECB will be more confident in taking further steps to exit from its accommodative monetary policy. And we expect the ECB to announce further reduction in its asset purchase program in September 2017 to be implemented in January 2018. By mid-18, the ECB will close its asset purchase program. So the flows will arrive to zero in mid-2018, but the stock liquidity will be abundant, quite large.